Hi, I'm Kevin Schroff, and my partner is David Baldwin. Yeah. We are both in the engineering program, Capilano University. Our project in Applied Sciences 140 was to build a biomimic robot. And this basically means it has to mimic a robot that mimics the flight of a bird. So the bird has to achieve flight solely on flapping of its wings. And this is known as an ornithopter. The design was named the Parkhawk by Sean Kincaid. And it was just the best suited design for the time given. It had to fly backwards. It had to turn. It had to be able to fly forward with the use of its wings. It had to be controlled by an RC controller. And it had to be able to take off from the ground. And another important part was it had to carry a kilogram. And the reason we chose the big design was because a larger ornithopter means it can probably carry more load. Personally, I found the wings most attractive. They looked like they could achieve flight the best, catch wind on the downstroke. I just thought that was just looked the best. We had to figure out where to put the spars, which are these carbon fiber rods inside the wing. One spar we placed other that the Parkhawk didn't was this spar right here. It goes from the base to the top of the wing. And what this whole spar does is creates more lift. Carbon fiber was chosen because it's flexible, it's strong, there's a low chance of breaking, it's light. So we chose these wings. They implement nylon ripstop and it doesn't fray easily. And it's also watertight and airtight, so air doesn't easily get through the wings. Another design problem was the tail. We had to figure out how the tail would tilt up and down, left to right, so that ornithopter could turn in flight. And what we did was we figured out two small motors would allow the full degree of motion we wanted to. This motor right here allowed the motor to rotate left and right. And this is all remote controlled to tilt the tail up and down. Was done by this servo motor right here. And a steel cable attached this motor to this motor and allowed, by pushing and pulling, allowed the entire tail to tilt up and down. There were some areas that we could have taken extra time in the design process. We didn't think most of the connecting parts together, because it just looked so easy on the Parkhawk. But since we didn't have the equipment and like drill presses, lathes, all that, we couldn't make them fit the way we wanted, so we had to make it ourselves. So for example, we had to think of a way to fix the rear of the wings to the body. And what we decided was two L brackets could just be fastened to the body. And then the angled spar in the wing could easily be attached with a screw. And how this works is it secures the angled spar to the rear of the body, so in a fixed position. And the back doesn't move, so this creates a twisting motion. And the twisting motion allows a forward propulsion in the wings. We had to attach the motor to gears and then attach the gears to a crankshaft, which allowed the wings to flap. And the problem we had was the gear ratio. It didn't produce enough torque in the beginning. So we had to gear down the ratio. So the motor spun 34 times faster than the crankshaft would. And what the lower speed of the crankshaft does is it creates more torque, and therefore it can lift more weight. Right now we're having problems securing the axle to the crankshaft. And this is because the axle is made out of steel and we do not have the equipment to drill through the steel. So right now we're trying to use a screw to pinch the axle to secure the axle to the gear. And right now what's happening is the screw that is going in is too large to go into the pre-made hole of the axle. And what we have to do is find a way to attach the gear and the axle together. We either have to find a screw large enough, or small enough, sorry, or we have to create a hole by ourselves with equipment. That is our largest problem right now, and that's why we are not able to achieve flapping motion right now. So we did use an Excel program, which ornithopter.de allowed us to do, and it helped us calculate the lift the ornithopter can produce, roughly based on the wingspan, the wing width, the coefficient of friction of the wings, the angle, all that. And it's a rough idea, still conceptual, but it gave us an idea if it could fly or not. And from the equations, it said technically our ornithopter could fly, which gives us hope. The design process was the most fun, most enjoyable. It was a lot less stressful. You can brainstorm. Nothing is a reality yet. If we connect the axle to the gear, I think we have a very good chance of getting the top five. So far, right now, that's the only problem we have left. It is a large problem, but it's our only problem left. And if we achieve finishing that, then I think we have a really good chance of getting top five. So this was my first project as an engineer. And I learned there's a great deal of project management involved. You have to keep in touch with your group. You have to plan as a group together. Another thing is, don't expect things to go to plan all the time. You have to think outside the box. That's what the engineers do. You have to think on your feet. You have to think outside the box. You have to think of your own ideas. And engineering is a lot of fun. It can be stressful, but in the end it makes you proud of what you've created, overcoming obstacles, all that.
You think you want to be an engineer after this?
I definitely do.
It's much better than your other courses?
It is. Okay. It's my favorite class so far.
Yeah.
Out of the semester. And so far it's teaching me the best life skills in general. Teaching me...
And just one last comment on this whole project.
So this project, although not working, not functioning properly, we are, as a group, proud of what we've created so far. We will keep improving it until the end of the semester. We want to see it achieve flight. We want to see it flap. We want to see it be in the top five. And yeah, we're proud of it. It's a good project.